tuo da gloria, non nobis domine 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 domine non nobis domine domine non nobis domine domine stars go out each night.
Eterna stella sei. Nella mia preghiera,
let this be our prayer.
Quanta fede c'è.
So we'll be saved. Sogniamo un mondo senza più violenza, un mondo di giustizia e di speranza.
Good evening. Okay, good. Good evening. Good. Good to see you. So is it thundering out? Was that what that was? No? Okay. Claps. Oh, yes, I see that. Is that Wanda over there? Thanks, Wanda. My biggest fan. I'm so excited you're here. Hey, thanks for coming. Do you all know where you are? This is the Bison Glee Club concert. Did you intend? It's a pretty quiet crowd. I guess maybe the last piece, you know, heartfelt. I guess you're kind of feeling melancholy after that last piece. Anyway, I'm Chris Matthews. I'm glad you came. Thanks for coming to the Bison Glee Club concert. We're looking forward to sharing some music with you and our work for the whole semester and really even the whole year. It's been a little bit of a challenge for us to figure out how to navigate COVID and only be able to rehearse part of the group at a time and eventually come back together and when to wear masks and when to take them off. But this group of guys has worked tremendously hard all year long. We've had a ton of fun, and we're so glad that we have an opportunity to perform for you live and to share some of what we've been working on. Hopefully serve as an encouragement to you, maybe help you lighten the load a bit and maybe put a few smiles on your face. A couple of years ago, I was in need of help. I've actually been in need of help for much longer than that, but something particularly I needed a little bit of help with Glee Club, and I can remember that Steve Sims and I started at OBU at the same time. We've both been here for 5 years, and I walked by Steve's office among his first weeks here, and he had proudly displayed his Bison Glee Club t-shirt, an alum of this group, and was so glad to be back at his alma mater and so proud of what Bison Glee Club had meant to him. And so a couple of years ago, I went to Dr. Sims and I said, would you mind sharing some of the responsibility of this group with me? And so last year in particular, Dr. Sims came and worked with this group once a week on just vocal technique, helping us understand better how to sing, how to produce sounds, how to think about our posture, and the group has improved so much. And it was a joy that year to watch Dr. Sims work with this group. The energy that he brought to them and the energy that they brought to him in working was just a sense of pride for me. I love sitting in the back and just watching him work. And so this year, when it came to the academic year, I said, you know, would you like to do a little bit more? And Dr. Sims said, absolutely. I'd love to have as much opportunity with this group as I could get. And I said, well, why don't you keep coming maybe a couple of days a week and do not only some vocal technique, but start conducting some pieces. And so he agreed to do that. So this is the time that Dr. Sims is coming back and taking the group. I'm going to let him come and conduct the group. That's no small thing for me. I don't let many people do that, but I'm so glad to give him a chance. And for me, it's a big deal. And so when Dr. Sims said, I'm going to pick this piece, I noticed that there was a solo. And so I went to Dr. Sims and I said, hey, since I, the director of Bison Glee Club, am letting you conduct a piece, you could let me do the solo. Thank you. And he smiled politely and said, I don't think so. So great. Okay, so I got over that and I was a little better after a couple of weeks. And so I went back to Dr. Sims and I said, listen, the young man you've picked for a solo is doing a marvelous job. That was the right choice. I noticed that this piece is accompanied, and I'm a pretty good pianist. So if you want to conduct and he can sing the solo and I'll play the piano. And Dr. Sims said, I think we'll just do it a cappella. Finally, since I am his boss and reminded him that I write his reviews, I said, you've got to have something for me to do. And he proudly gave me one job. So I'm going to perform my job now. Part of that is introducing Dr. Sims. Would you help me welcome Dr. Steve Sims to the platform?
Wrong mic. He did it well.
I can do it again.
There you go.
You've got to hold on to the rock of ages. Hold on to the cornerstone. Gotta stand strong on the sure foundation. Surrounded by the fortress strong. And when all the storms of life are raging,
hold on.
Take a mighty earthquake to shake the ground you stand on. Then life can change like a hurricane and blow all the plans you planned on. The ground is gonna shake and the wind is gonna blow. Who are you gonna trust and where you gonna go? You gotta
hold on to the rock of ages. Hold on to the cornerstone.
Gotta stand strong on the sure foundation,
surrounded by the fortress strong.
And when all the storms of life are raging,
hold on.
You know sometimes when life is easy, it's so easy to keep the faith, to be grateful for every blessing, when every blessing comes our way. When life shakes us to our very soul, who you gonna trust and where you gonna go? You gotta
hold on. Surrounded by the fortress.
to hold on to the rock. Hold on to the rock.
Well, he told me I could talk a little bit if I wanted to. But those of you who know me know that I like to talk. And I could talk for days on end about just about anything. But I'm not going to do that to you because you're only here for a certain amount of time and you want to be able to enjoy tonight and not walk away thinking, man, I wish that guy would stop talking. So it has been my pleasure to work with the Glee Club this year and do some coaching with them. And so when Dr. Matthews and I, we were talking about some pieces for this semester and about me conducting and what pieces I would like to do, I saw this one and heard Bright Morning Stars. This is a traditional Appalachian song. And it's been quite a joy to work with these gentlemen over this semester. It's gone by really fast. We're almost at the end of the semester. And it has been really fast, on the fast track getting here. But this has brought back great, great memories for me to be able to work with this men's choir again. It's been a little over 20 years since I was in this group, so don't do the math, but yes. But it has been a great joy, and I mean that, a great joy to be able to work with these fine gentlemen and work with them as we create music alongside with Dr. Matthews. And so, yeah, I don't always tell my boss no. That conversation really didn't happen. I'm sure you caught on to that. But this next piece is Bright Morning Stars. Our soloist will be Jacob Jungheim. Andrew Hill. I'm trying to get all my names here. Gannon Dubin. And we're going to have Devin Armstrong. And also, where are you? Luke Morris.
Bright morning stars are rising, bright morning stars are rising, bright morning stars are rising, day is a breaking in my
Thank you. Eternal, ringing on the farther shore. As I near those swollen waters with their deep and solemn roar,
hallelujah, 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 there's the Lamb, hallelujah,
hallelujah, glory to the great I am. My souls all sing with sorrow, fading as the light of day passes swiftly o'er those waters to the city far away.
Glory to kingdom, main of that good news.
Main of that good news.
I got a crown up in the kingdom, main of that good news.
Main of that good news.
I'm not gonna lay down this world, gonna shoulder up on my cross, gonna take it home unto my Jesus. Main of that good news, good news.
I got a harp up in the kingdom, main of that good news.
Main of that good news.
I got a harp up in the kingdom, ain't of that good news.
Ain't of that good news. I'm gonna lay down this world, gonna shoulder up my shoulder up, gonna take it home unto my Jesus. Ain't of that good news,
good news.
I got a robe up in the kingdom, ain't of that good news.
Ain't of that good news.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Andrew Hill, the president of the Bison Glee Club, and I'm sure those of you familiar with the culture of the Bison Glee Club won't be surprised to learn that we've been doing just a little bit of scheming. But first, I would like to just thank you all for coming out today. It's just so great to have you all out here to support our music making, and we're so grateful for that. So just applause to all of you. Thank you so much. But before we get on with the rest of our concert, the Supreme Executive Council of very important people in the Bison Glee Club has a brief message that we would like to provide.
Hello. My name is Cameron Clark. I'm the accompanist and also an honorary member of the Supreme Executive Council of Important People of Bison Glee Club. And I'd like to introduce some seniors who have put a lot of their time here at OBU and a lot of their work into this ensemble, and we want to thank them. And so first, Caleb Gray, graduating senior. And Casey Cox, also a graduating senior. Thank you guys for coming out again. It's a pleasure to be able to perform like this again after a long year. So thank you.
Hello, I'm Kyle Dalbaugh. I'm the vice president of the Bison Glee Club. And I have the privilege to ask Dr. Matthews to come to the center of the stage. This is the first ever Bison Glee Club Excellence Award that we're going to give Dr. Matthews for his 5 years of service with the Bison Glee Club. And we're just so appreciative of his talents, of his gifts, of his hard work and dedication to Bison Glee Club. Now I'm going to pass it to Chaplain Naaman Henniger, and he has a prayer for us.
As he said, my name is Naaman Henniger, and I'm the chaplain, not Nathan, so thank you for that. I remember the first time I walked in the Bison Glee Club, and I sat down, and I looked at Dr. Matthews, and he said, "You're not Nathan." And a little backstory, I have an identical twin brother named Nathan. But he said, "You're not Nathan." And I said, "No, I'm not." And so from that moment on, just began, just a series of like less than good jokes, you know what I mean? But they were sometimes good. But we really do appreciate him. We thank him for his many years of service as our conductor, as our director, but also as our spiritual advisor. In so many ways, he's helped us through some stuff, and we appreciate him in a lot of ways. So I'm going to ask him to come down here and his family as well. So wherever his family is, just come down like right here. Just like right down there. And we're... wherever his family is. Okay. Yeah, and we just really want to pray over you. Just to appreciate you guys. Yeah. We'll wait on them. But we all can come over. Please bow with me. Dear Father, we thank you for the Matthews family. We thank you for what they mean to this university, Lord. I pray for them, Father, Lord, that they would just continue to seek your will. I thank you for the impact that he has had on the fellow members of Bison Glee Club. I thank you for who he is in you, Lord, and I pray that he would continue to seek your grace and your goodness in all that he does. In your name I pray, amen.
Sun is shining in the sky. There ain't a cloud inside. It stopped raining. Everybody's in a play. And don't you know, it's a beautiful new day. Hey,
rolling down the avenue. See how the sun shines brightly in the city. On the streets where once was pity, Mr. Blue. Sky is living here today. Hey!
Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long, so long.
Where did we go wrong?
Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long, so long.
Where did we go wrong?
Hey, you with the pretty face. Welcome to the human race. A celebration, Mr. Blue Sky's up there waiting. And today is the day we've waited for. Ah.
Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long, so long.
Where did we go?
Look around, see what you do. Everybody smiles at you. Hey there, Mr. Blue. We're so pleased to be with you. Look around, see what you do. Everybody smiles at you.
Mr. Blue, you did it right. But soon comes Mr. Night. Creeping over.
Sky, please tell us why you asked to hide away for so long,
so long.
Where did we go wrong? Hey there, Mr. Blue, we're so pleased to be with you. Look around, see what you do. Everybody smiles at you.
Was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Bully of Tea. The winds blew up her bow, dipped down, oh blow, my bully boys, blow.
Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tugging is done, we'll take our leave and go. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tugging is done, we'll take our leave and go.
She had not been 2 weeks from shore when down on the ship a blue whale bore. The captain called all hands and swore
he'd take that whale in tow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tugging is done, we'll take our leave and go.
Before the boat had hit the water, the whale's tail came up and caught. All hands to the side, harpooned and fought, but she died down below.
Soon may the whalemen come to bring us sugar and tea
dough.
Soon may the wellerman come.
We can't say that word. We just can't.
What word?
R-U-M.
Well?
Don't say it.
Oh, my God.
The man has a point.
Thank you. And thanks for laughing. Most of the time, the jokes that I think are funny, no one thinks is funny. So I appreciate you laughing at our jokes. Thanks. They're coming back, I hope. So when I began this role 5 years ago, I was elated by the opportunity to join the heritage, the legacy, the traditions of the Bison Glee Club. You know, there's a great reference in scripture that Paul uses that says some plant and some water, but it's God who harvests. 82 years ago now, Warren Angel planted a seed that was the Bison Glee Club and poured his life's work into that, watering, tending to that. And others have come along and watered and pruned and taken care of. Mickey Cox and James Vernon, who's here, I think, and Randall Bradley and others who've come along, and they've watered and they tended this crazy group of guys, helped them to sing, helped them to laugh when college is stressful, helped them to think about the things of God and heaven, and to form a fraternity of men who would form a strong bond of friendship. I feel like when I came 5 years ago, what I got to do was just sit under the shade of the Bison Glee Club. I feel like I just got to sit down next to it and enjoy it. I know that there are many alum here. You all have been great to me. You've been such an encouragement to tell me stories, to help me understand the traditions. I feel a strong part of the Bison Glee Club, and I'm so proud of that. I will take that with me wherever I go. This, of course, is my last time to conduct it, but I'm so happy that it's going to be in the capable hands of Dr. Sims. And I look forward to coming back to reunions. I look forward to watching what this group does in year number 90 and 100 and 120 and 100. I probably won't see 150, but if we could get there, it'd be great. Part of the mission of this group, to promote brotherhood, to develop musicianship, to be of service to the university, to further the mission of Jesus, by studying, rehearsing, and performing outstanding sacred and secular pieces. It's always been a part of this group to have fun with the secular pieces. So if you would allow us the opportunity, we're going to bring back one of those traditional songs, Ezekiel Saw the Wheel. Dry Bones.
Dry bones, Ezekiel connected them.
Dry bones now hear the word of the Lord. Your toe bone connected to ya. Foot bone connected to ya. Heel bone connected to ya. Ankle bone connected to ya. Leg bone connected to ya. Knee bone connected to ya. Thigh bone connected to ya. Your hip bone connected to ya. Your back bone connected to ya. Your shoulder bone connected to ya. Your neck bone connected to ya. Head bone, now hear the word of the Lord. Them bones gonna walk around. Them bones gonna do them bones gonna walk around. Now hear the word of the Lord. Disconnect them, dry bones, disconnect them.
Check. Now, can you hear me? I believe it was 1938, the year that this group started, that Dean Angel was on a train and wrote a song called Ode to Friendship. Fallen in love with this song. This group sings it often every semester. And so we haven't been able to because we haven't had concerts because of COVID, but we try at the end of the concert to invite all of our alum up. Now, I recognize that we're still in the season of COVID, and if you're uncomfortable coming on stage, then we certainly understand. We think we can do this. But we're going to put our mask on, and if you're one of our alum, it would be comfortable coming up. We have some music, if you've forgotten it, and we would love just to sing Ode to Friendship with you. So if you want to take a minute to come, we're going to put our mask on, and you can join us. If not, then you just enjoy, and know we're so glad that you came to our concert tonight. Thank you for coming. Don was actually on the train as the conductor when Dean Angel wrote this piece. I'm teasing. You're not. You all are a really tough crowd tonight. Now, but what's really cool is that Don Clark, a member of the Bison Glee Club, was Steve Sims' voice teacher when Steve was at OBU. So it's pretty cool, Don. Thanks for coming. Yeah, glad you're here. Okay.
Sure.
came. Thank you so much for coming. Y'all have a good evening tonight.